Well, due to the current climate that we're in at the moment, the fishing industry has seen a massive influx of anglers taking up the sport, which is fantastic to see. There's nothing better than getting yourself a set of rods, getting out to the pond and catching your quarry. So with that being said, we're going to try and educate a few of you guys that may be new to the sport so that you can put the fish back into the lake in as good as condition as you caught them in. So we're going to start with some of the equipment that you're going to need to keep the fish as safe as possible. So I'm just going to talk you through the mats that you can get, because there's a few that you'll find on the market that are fairly different from one another. So I'm just going to run you through briefly of what each mat does and its uses. Now, this is the Karpmaster Deluxe mat. And as you can see, where it's got its deluxe name from, it's got some serious padding in the bottom there. So when you put the fish with inside the mat here, it's got lots of cushion in there, especially if you get a big carp. Like you can see, this is a fairly sizable mat. We've got a big 40 pounder in here. It's always going to be protected within the walls of the mat itself. As I mentioned, it's got these retaining walls. This will stop the fish from slipping out. So if you've got a bit of uneven ground like we've got here, fish isn't going to slip off of the mat and cause itself damage on the grass or gravel that you may have your mat on. That doesn't mean that you can just leave the fish within the mat and walk off elsewhere. You've always got to be on top of the fish at all times. So if the fish is a little bit lively, it's on the mat, done a little bit berserk, then you've got this retaining flap here. This will, 9 times out of 10, calm the fish down. Another feature that's on this mat is you've got a side pocket here where you can put your forceps in there, you can put your propolis in there. Propolis, we'll get onto that in a little bit. It's your carp care equipment, can go within that pocket there. And it's outside of the mat, so it will never come into contact with the fish, cause any damage whatsoever. So that's the Karpmaster Deluxe mat in a nutshell. It comes in this standard version and it comes in the XL version as well. So if you're going abroad, catching absolute giants, you're gonna want the XL mat. So the next mat in line, which technically isn't a mat, as you'll see that this is completely different from the first mat that we showed you, this is the Karpmaster Cradle. And as you'll see, it's actually off the ground, hence the name, a cradle. So basically it's sat within a frame. You've got some padded walls either side. You've got drainage either side as well so that they don't fill up with water and you're sat here with a bath and a fish inside it. With that in mind, if the fish is going a little bit berserk, we've still got the flap over the top. So if the fish is going a little bit crazy within your mat there, you can put the flap over the top. 9 times out of 10, that calms the fish down. The beauty of the cradle being off the ground is that when you've got the fish with inside the cradle here, it can't build up momentum and flip itself out. So it's confined within this space here. Another beauty with the cradles is you've obviously got feet. So if you've got uneven ground, you can extend the feet with on the cradle and you can keep it all nice and level. Now these Karpmaster cradles, they come in 2 sizes. You've got the standard version, this one here, and you've got the XL version as well. So if you're going abroad, a lot of fisheries abroad now only allow you to take cradles. So you're gonna want the XL versions for when you've got their massive carp within your cradle. So this is a Karpmaster Air Mat, my personal favorite, this one. So you get your pump, blow this up. You've got 2 chambers here, so once you've blown them up, you can see it's fairly raised off of the ground. You then put your padded mat in the very bottom of it and you've got a nice padded secure area for any fish that you catch. So once you've blown the mat up, as you can see, you've got these secure retaining walls all the way around, so the fish is nice and secure when it's within inside the mat itself. Now, some fisheries, especially when they've got larger carp in, you're not actually allowed to take the fish out of the water. So this is where this mat is ideal for you. Again, this mat comes with a retaining cover. Now you can use that on top of the mat when it's used this way. The other beauty with this is you can use it the opposite way round as well. So this almost gives you a bit of a cradle effect. You can obviously put the cover over the top of this material here, and then that keeps the fish nice and safe within the retaining walls of the air mat. So the next item of carp care equipment that we're going to be looking at is slings. Now these can be used for retaining fish in a very short period of time. Not only that, transporting fish to your mats and also for weighing your fish. So these are the Karpmaster STR slings. Now STR stands for short term retention. You do not want to be holding fish for long periods of time. You literally want to be retaining your fish whilst you're sorting out your camera equipment or blowing up your mat, getting your mat set up whilst you're on the bank, whilst the fish is safely retained in the edge. Now, as you can see, these come in XL version and the standard version. Now, depending on what mat you've got within our range, if you've got the standard version, you obviously want the standard sling, or if you've got the XL mats, then you're gonna want the XL sling. As you can see, these slings come complete with a stink bag. Now, the stink bags are for, obviously, if you've retained a fish, weighed a fish, and they're obviously all slimy and horrible. If you put them within the stink bags themselves, put them in your van, it's not gonna smell, it's not gonna stink your van out, but when you get them home, you do need to dry your slings out. Now, the reasons why you dry a sling out is you're not gonna be transporting disease from one venue to another. If you go to any venue with a bone dry sling, you can be sure that you're not transporting disease. And whilst we're on that subject, be sure that your mats and your nets are always bone dry before you go from one venue to the other. The actual arms themselves, they have full HD foam running the whole length of the arms, which keeps this sling afloat. Now, this foam is a reduced diameter, so these slings can be rolled up a lot more compactly. In between the two foams, as you can see there, you've got a meshed panel. This enables you to see the fish with inside the sling itself, being sure that the fish is sat upright. The sling also features two zips. Not only that, it has retention clips, so that ensures that the zips don't come apart whilst your fish is with inside the sling. As well as that, inside it's got zip baffles as well. That ensures that the fish doesn't get into contact with the zip itself. The sling also features double handles at both ends. So if you've got a fish of a lifetime within the sling itself, your mate can help you safely transport the fish onto the bank. So another vital bit in your carp care kit is a water bucket. Now, you can obviously use your standard bucket, which may have bait inside, or you can get yourself a collapsible bucket like this one here, which is nice and easy to obviously transport. You can chuck it within your mat. It's taking up no room whatsoever. Now, the reasons why you need a water bucket is you always need to be keeping that mat wet as well as your sling wet, and not only that, the fish as well, of course. So as you can see, this water bucket is collapsible. If I extend it out, see, it's a fairly large water bucket. It comes with a rope so that you can chuck it out into the deep margin and be sure that you can get a full bucket of water. It also comes with its carry strap as well, so it's nice and solid and it's never gonna buckle under any water that you put with inside the bucket. So always ensure that whenever you've caught your fish that you use fresh water. Don't be leaving water within this bucket out in the blazing sun, especially in the summertime, where the water can get seriously hot and damage the fish. So last but no means least is this stuff here. Everyone should have this in their carp care kit, and it's propolis. So where you would actually use this is on things like hook holds. So once you've taken the hook out of the fish's mouth, if you dry the area off with a little bit of cloth and then apply some propolis on there, you can seal it off by a little bit of water. It's actually generated from bees, this stuff, so you'll notice that it will change color when you put water on it, and then it gets a waxy film and that seals off the wound. You should always check the fish over as well for any scratches, sores that they may have. And once you've sealed it off, what it almost does is apply like a plaster onto the wound. That stops any sort of bacteria getting into that wound and the fish getting further on infection. So you can pick this stuff up from, you know, eBay, Amazon. I believe that you can get it in Holland and Barrett as well. This bottle here, it was two of these bottles for £10. That would easily do me for a season, that one bottle there. So this is definitely an item everyone should have within their carp care kit. So when you've actually caught yourself a fish, which unfortunately I failed to do today, may I add, but once you've actually got that fish in the net, the first thing I always try and do is unhook the fish whilst it's still in the water, obviously within the confines of your net. Reasons why you would do this is this can be where a lot of the fish's mouth damage can happen. Now, with a lot of the rigs and different types of components that are out there these days, these can get caught up within the mesh. And if you just lift the fish out of the water, that can obviously get caught in the mesh and tear the hook from the fish's mouth. So always, always, if you can, try and unhook the fish whilst it's in the net. Now, if that's not possible, which sometimes it isn't, then there's a few things you can do to ensure that you don't damage the fish's mouth. One of them things is make sure that the fish is at the very bottom of the mesh of the net. If you're going to use the net to take the fish out of the water, then make sure there's no components caught up within the net. Undo your net, roll it down, and then support the fish where its pectoral fins are. Ensure that they are flat to the fish's body. So you do this just by obviously running your hands down its body and checking that both pectoral fins are flat to the body. Roll the net down, grab hold of the fish and support it and transport it to the mat. There's another way you can do this as well. You can obviously use a sling, so i.e. collapse the net. It's still ensuring that the fish is in the very bottom of the mesh, and then pass the net into the sling and then check the fins whilst it's inside the sling itself. Once they're flat to the body, you can roll your sling up with the net and everything inside and then transport the fish to the mat as well. And you'll be sure that all of the fish go to the mat safely and then they go back safely as well. Now, if you're lucky enough to catch yourself an absolute giant, then it's always worth trying to get somebody else to help you. Just leave the fish in the net, it'll be absolutely fine. Ensure that the net's obviously secure so that the fish can't swim off with it, of course, and get hold of someone. The fish will be absolutely fine. As long as it's in a decent depth of water and it's sat upright, then get hold of someone else to come and give you a hand. Then you can both put the fish in the sling. You've got the double handles there. You can always ensure that that fish is safe going to the mat and then back to the water as well. So that's a look at some of the carp care items that we do. If there's any questions out there that you want answered, then pop your questions on the comments below and we'll do our utmost to get back to you.